For millions of years, humans have been perfecting their sensory abilities. Eyesight, combined with brain power, allows people to identify faces, recognize objects, perceive their environment, and then take action based on those observations. At the University of Maryland, a renowned research and education center is transferring these same human sensory skills to modern computing platforms. The Center for Automation Research, known as CfAR, is developing computer vision applications that are important in our lives, including technologies for public safety, healthcare, education and entertainment, and more.
We've been working on the problem of computer vision for over 50 years, trying to give computers the ability to see with the same type of accuracy that people do, to be able to recognize everyday objects, everyday actions of people, and the context in which they're being done.
While CfAR has almost 24 faculty and research scientists in its 4 unique labs, it can trace its roots back to the dedicated efforts of one man.
The center was established by Azriel Rosenfeld, who was a research professor here in College Park. And Azriel really was the founder of the whole field of computer vision. He wrote the first textbook, and he started the first journal, and he started the first conference, and he probably wrote most of the first few hundred papers.
Significant discoveries in computer vision have already been made at Maryland, yet challenges remain.
The holy grail here is to understand what's in an image, what's in a video, who is in it, what they're doing, when the image was taken, where the image was taken. So we consider all of this as inference problem. Given a single image or a video sequence, how much information can you gather from there?
Much of the work in CfAR involves obtaining information from images or video that have multiple subjects, moving objects, or that may not be in perfect focus.
Now, when you want to do video-based face recognition, you have to incorporate the motion of the face, as well as the fact that the pose will vary, because people don't just look at the camera when the video is running, and many surveillance cameras have very low resolution. So you have to deal with all of these problems together.
CfAR works with data from multiple sources, building software tools that can quickly analyze and process electronic media and important documents, much of it in languages other than English. In healthcare, the center is designing visualization tools that allow medical professionals to gain new insight into serious conditions like traumatic brain injury or Parkinson's disease. Also underway are projects in virtual and augmented reality. These immersive interactive platforms let people see and use the information that matters most. To see where important news is happening, check out Newsstand, which can access more than 10,000 news feeds simply by clicking on a map location.
Newsstand provides a map query interface to access data such as news and really other data as well that exploits the notion of spatial synonyms. This means that you don't have to know what you're looking for in your search.
The application is available for mobile devices, allowing users to view news articles, photographs, and video clips in multiple languages.
The audience for Newsstand is limitless. Anybody who is a news junkie is going to love being able to get access to things by location.
Other interactive tools developed at CfAR include Leaf Snap, where you can take a mobile snapshot of a leaf and immediately determine its species. There's also Bird Snap, an electronic field guide that can identify thousands of species of birds in the wild. We're creating new technology that combines sound waves with light waves to build a 3D acoustic camera. The device has many potential applications, from improving security systems, to enhancing concert hall acoustics, to protecting industrial workers' hearing. The center has a strong interest in autonomous robotics, combining artificial intelligence, computer vision, and language processing software to develop robots able to think and act on their own.
We are one of very few groups in the world that work with robots and language. The best way to interact with robots is to speak to them, and they should answer you back. In order to implement this, the robot has to have an understanding of the meaning of the words, which becomes very challenging.
In addition to language, the robots need to be able to see and identify objects and clearly understand what it is they're looking at.
One of our main projects is understanding actions of manipulations. So our work is on providing tools in order to track hands, but also understand how they are involved in the action-object relationship in order to predict motion very early on.
When these cognitive robots that see and reason and act in the world appropriately, it will change fundamentally our societies.
Protecting public spaces, helping diagnose brain injuries, building new computing platforms to interact with media, with nature, and with other people in a digital world. These are just some of the projects underway in the Center for Automation Research at the University of Maryland. Where is our research headed next? Come and join us to find out.